Everyone, how's your day? What did you think? What did you see? And what did you find out the new one? Let's talk about my day. I have a one class and I prepare many food. That's why I go to the market twice time. And actually, this is the new, recipe to make the new food, so I was a little nervous to make it, but I love to challenge. Even if I ruined my new food, it's okay because I love to challenge the new one. I don't know my new food is delicious or not, but it takes some time to later then I will say something about my new food. And what did you do? And I read book and I love to write down some essay. This day I prepare some book. That's why I have to write down many essay. I collect some essays in my notebook. Someday I'm gonna send this story to some publisher. I expect my book come out in this world. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna read the new vocabulary. Bold, brilliance, curve, condemnation, confident, covenant, enable, expert, fade, harden, overwhelm, prepare, recognize, condemnation, remain, remove, represent, bear. Corinthians 2. But the only letter of recommendation we need is your service. Your lives are a letter written in our heart, and everyone can read it and recognize our good work among you. Wow, it's very wonderful sentences. Your life is the letter. Wow. And clearly, you are a letter from Christ prepared by us. It is written not with pen and ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. It is carved not on stone, but on human hearts. We are confident of all this because of our great trust in God through Christ. It is not that we think we can do anything of the lasting value. By our service, our only power and success come from God. Wow, that's really agree with this sentence. He's the one who has enabled us to prepare, represent his new covenant. This is the covenant not of written law, but of the Spirit. The old way ends in the death. In the new way, the Holy Spirit gives life. The glory of the new covenant, that old system of law etched in the stone led to death. Yet it began with such glory that the people of Israel could not bear to look at Moses' face. For his face shone with the glory of God, even though the brightness was already fading away. Shouldn't we accept far greater glory when the Holy Spirit is giving life? If the old covenant, which brings condemnation, is glorious, how much more glorious is the new covenant, which makes us right with God? In fact, that the first glory was not glorious at all, prepared with the overwhelming glory of the new covenant. So, if the old covenant, which has been set aside, was full of glory, then the new covenant, which remains forever, has far greater glory. Since this new covenant gives us such confidence, we can be very bold. We are not like Moses who put a veil over his face so the people of Israel would not see the glory fading away. But the people's minds were hardened, and even to this day, whenever the old covenant being read, a veil cover their minds so that cannot understand the truth. But its veil can be removed only by believing in Christ. Yes, even today, when they read Moses' writing, their hearts are covered with that veil they do not understand. But whenever anyone turns to the Lord, then the veil is taken away.
Wow!
Now, the Lord is the Spirit, and whenever the Spirit of the Lord is.
Wow, amazing.
So everybody have their own veil. So even if they hear or they look at, but they cannot realize what is the real truth. But if their veils fade away, far away, they can see exactly the Lord has shown us. So it's very important to take off your veil by Holy Spirit.